Rat could do. She had not intended to pock paving stone with acid holes or fill the harbor basin with sunken ships. That damage had been incidental. We had seen the harm that one dragon fighting on behalf of a city could do. He stood on the deck and tried to count the oncoming dragons. He stopped at 10. 10 times dead was very dead indeed. The slaves chained to their oars were praying. He was tempted to join them. The dragons had flown through the night, ignoring cold and fitful rainfall. Sintara had expected to be exhausted by dawn, but they were not. They had flown on as the sun rose and on as it climbed into the sky. They had flown as if they had but one mind, reverting to the animals that perhaps dragons once had been. Mercor led their formation, and Sintara had been proud to fly to his right. Blue-black Kalo had taken his left, and then Sestakan and Valapur. Those three, she knew somehow, had been a long time with the golden dragon, perhaps swimming with him as serpents once. Quarrel they might among themselves, but now there was a common enemy to fight and vanquish. All differences among them were gone. Even their thirst for silver had been suppressed. 15 strong, they had risen to Tintaglia's pride for vengeance. Silversmith lumbered along at the tail of the line. Copper-elped and flew strongly, her early awkwardness scarcely a memory for her now. And ridiculous red Hebe blew whatever she would, now part of the formation, now trailing it, now blind to one side. Her slender scarlet riders sang as they flew, a song of anger and vengeance, but also one that praised the beauty of angry dragons in flight and praised glorious victory for them. Ridiculous, and ridiculous that she and the others enjoyed it so. Vimara had complained more than once about how freely the dragons used their glamour to compel their keepers to tend them. Yet not once had she ever admitted the power that human flattery and praise in song could exert over dragons. She was not the only dragon who flew with her mind full of Rapskor's glorious images of exotically beautiful dragons triumphing over every obstacle. They had flown straight, not following the river's meandering course. Dawn had come earlier for them than it had for the ships on the river's surface. The tall trees that surrounded this section of the Rainwild River also blocked the earliest rays of the sun. The dragons had flown over the treetops, feeling the warmth of the sun mimic their weary wings. Then, as the trees gave way to the open space of the river, they had seen their enemies in the distance.
Vengeance, my beautiful ones, jewels of the day! We will visit death on them, and death so glorious they will die praising you! Destroy them all! Sink their ships!
Kalo's trumpet call of fury rang against the dead gray sky. Rapskull laughed aloud.
Oh no, my mighty one! There is